Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends. Now we are going to do a new concept, that is thermodynamical equilibrium. So what is thermodynamical equilibrium and what are the criteria to maintain thermodynamical equilibrium? Let us talk about it. So friends, let us talk about thermodynamical equilibrium or thermodynamic equilibrium. So it means that a system is said to be thermodynamic equilibrium when the state functions of the systems do not change with time. So what are the state functions? This state function is the one which we have did earlier also, which we have did a video also in that case. And in that case, we have got to know that pressure, volume, temperature, internal energy or enthalpy, this all are basically the state functions. That means this depends on the initial state and the final state of a particular system and not depends on the path of the system. So that was basically the state function. So what does this say is as this state function should not change with time, and then only that kind of system will attain thermodynamic equilibrium. So what does this talks about? So let me give you a short example of it. Suppose if a gas has been enclosed, again I am talking about the same gas, because in this case we are going to talk by taking these examples like we have did in earlier lectures also. Suppose if I have taken a cylinder, and in that cylinder, suppose if I have enclosed a gas covered with a frictionless piston, as you could see. So this is a rough diagram that I have drawn. So suppose this is a cylinder in which the gas has been enclosed, the gas particles are been enclosed. So in this case, the pressure will be having a particular value in which the gas has been maintained. It will have a fixed volume, that as you could see, it will have a fixed volume, as well as the temperature will also be, suppose if it has kept, it has been kept constant. And so in this case, what we are observing is that even though it is a frictionless piston, and suppose if we have to maintain an equilibrium, so this pressure, this volume and this temperature, there would be many state function, as you know, state function like pressure volume rather than this also. So this should not change with time. Suppose what happens if the piston falls after few time, or suppose if the piston tries to compress this gas, so what will happen is the piston, if suppose after a few time have compressed the gas, so it is but obvious that the volume is the first that we could observe, that the volume has been changed. And we know that the volume is inversely proportional to the pressure. So in this case, if the pressure is being changed, so volume is also being changed and the pressure is also being changed. Suppose I am naming it as V1 and P1, suppose in this case. So I could see that the equilibrium is not being maintained in this case. Why? Because after a few times, even this parameter changes. So that is the reason, thermodynamic equilibrium is not being maintained. So to maintain a thermodynamic equilibrium, the thing is the parameters like the state function, this should remain constant throughout the whole process, and it should not change according to the time, or the time passes, it should not change with the time. So that is the main thing to maintain a thermodynamic equilibrium for a particular system. So let me give you a few other details also that should we should consider so as to maintain the thermodynamic equilibrium. The first one is, that is, the macroscopic variables like pressure, volume and temperature remains unchanged with the time when we are talking about a thermodynamic equilibrium system. So in this case, the pressure, volume and temperature remains unchanged. It should not change and it remains unchanged. The next one is, the chemical composition does not change with time. Again, the chemical composition will also not change with the time. The thing is, suppose if two gas are being enclosed in a particular cylinder, and if you want to react it by giving a high pressure, so if we have kept the pressure as it is and So what will happen is, it will have a particular pressure, it will have a particular volume as well as particular temperature. So we are not changing the pressure. So that's the reason they won't, suppose, react with each other. So therefore, in this case, the chemical composition will also not be changed when the gas has been kept in a container. So in this case, I have given an example. Suppose if a gas has been kept in a container. So to maintain a thermodynamic equilibrium, so the chemical composition will not change with the time. So that is the second thing that we usually observe in thermodynamic equilibrium. And the next one is, the equilibrium can be shifted in any direction by changing variables through infinitesimal value and can be recovered to initial state. So this means what? Again, I will take the example of the piston in this case. So as you could see that this is a frictionless piston, so this could come down after a few times. Suppose if I came down, so what will happen? The parameters, that is the pressure, volume and temperature, they will have effect on it. Suppose if this is under thermodynamic equilibrium, suppose. Suppose if it is under thermodynamic equilibrium, so what will happen is, and it is because of, if the frictionless piston, suppose if it comes down, while the gas will also try to oppose that. So in this case, both are opposite forces. So in this case, both the forces are balancing so that there should be no change in any of the state function. So this maintains the thermodynamic equilibrium. And talking about the next thing, and because they both are being in a balanced way, that is the opposing force and the force which is letting the gas to expand, because a pressure is been applied or a force is been applied through the frictionless piston. So both the forces are being balanced, but in this case, since they are being in a thermodynamic equilibrium, so the process can be reversed also. Suppose both the forces are being the same, almost same, because the driving force as well as the opposing force, the both are the same. That's the reason the thermodynamic equilibrium is being maintained. Suppose if I have changed an infinitesimal, suppose if I have given an infinitesimal change among these two to anyone, so now the thermodynamic equilibrium would be maintained and I could reverse the process, or I could shift the process. How? Suppose if I have increased a force that is the opposing force. So what I could observe is that if the force has been applied from the system to the surrounding, then this will move up, this piston will move up. As well as I could also say it as, suppose if I have increased the force which is letting the piston to move down, suppose if I have increased the force here also, again this piston could come down. So I could change the process. So I could basically reverse the process. But this maintenance can also, because the process can be changed, so by giving a particular amount of energy or particular amount of changing in variables, what I could do is I can attain or I could recover the initial state also. Suppose if I have increased the force, or suppose if I have increased the external pressure, so what will happen? The piston will come down. And suppose I have to maintain the initial state, so what I have to do, I have to decrease the pressure. So again, the piston will go up. So in this case, what I can do is, this thermodynamic equilibrium gives me a freedom that I could reverse the process either in a forward direction or either in a backward direction. So this is nothing but thermodynamic equilibrium. So yes, there are few thermodynamic equilibriums that I want to mention in this video. That is, there are three types of thermodynamic equilibrium. The first one is mechanical equilibrium. So it says that when no work is done on the system or by the system, it is known as mechanical equilibrium. The same if we consider the piston that we have drawn in the few seconds earlier. So if the work should not be done, suppose if the work is not done by the system or to the system, if work is not done on the system, so what will happen is the piston, or in that case, suppose if I have considered, so even that won't be moved. So in this case, there won't be no work because I have not changed any kind of variable. So in this case, since those variables are not be changed, so therefore no work would be done in that system, and that kind of equilibrium that is being maintained will be said to be a mechanical equilibrium. Talking about the next one, that is thermal equilibrium. It says that when temperature remains constant throughout the system including the surrounding, it is known as thermal equilibrium. Suppose if the system and the surrounding, the both the system and the surrounding has suppose the same temperature. In this case, I could say that suppose the system has a temperature of T1 is for system, while the temperature T2 is for surrounding. And it says that when the temperature remains constant throughout the system means there should be no change in temperature. That is actually when delta T, which is means T2 minus T1 or T1 minus T2, it can be or it should be zero. And in that case, it would be considered to be a thermal equilibrium. So this were the two equilibrium, but now talking about the last one, that is chemical equilibrium. So when composition of the system remains constant and definite, it is known as chemical equilibrium. Suppose in any kind of process, if the composition of the system is remaining constant or it is not being changed, because the variables like pressure, volume and temperature, if they are not being altered or they are not being changed, then it is but obvious that the chemical composition of that particular system also won't change. So at that a kind of equilibrium where the chemical is not being changing or the there is no change in chemical reaction or in process, that kind of equilibrium will be said to be chemical equilibrium. So this all are basically, that is mechanical, that is chemical equilibrium. So this all are or thermal equilibrium. So this all are basically related to thermodynamic equilibrium itself. So these are the properties or these are the details of thermodynamic equilibrium. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.